If you love Baltimore sports, you'll love WNST.net.
What are you doing this Thursday night? Why not drop by Sullivan's Steakhouse on Lake Street? A fabulous dining room, a sexy bar, jazz music, $5 martinis, and food specials. Seafood, steaks, and value. That's Sully's.
Welcome in, folks. My name is John McKay with WNST.net. Sitting here with Bob Haney, Adonis Cyberman, and Dundalk. Welcome in, Bob.
It's good to be here, John. Thanks for inviting me.
Oh, absolutely. My pleasure, as always.
I'm honored. Thank you.
Question, Bob. You've been doing a radio show now for, what, 8 years, I guess it is?
This is my 9th year. I'll start my 10th year at NSP in September.
How do you work it in between the weightlifting and the marathons? An obvious, busy physical activity.
Well, that's a very interesting question, and we only have 5 minutes, so I can't get into it all.
Talk away, buddy, talk away.
But, it's a tough game, but, I work my schedule around my wife's schedule, and since she makes more money than I do, I pretty much do whatever she tells me, and that's work 10 to 2, and do it with a smile on my face, and of course it's an easy game, so who am I to complain?
Oh, I know that's
Oh, yes, as you can tell, I am a buff. It's hydroxycutite. I gotta get my liver checked.
Well, Bob, when you got started, how did you get started exactly?
Well, I went to Broadcasting Institute of Maryland back in 1990, and I got my first job, if you will, in radio with the Washington Bullets. Not radio, but in sports. The Bullets had an office at First Maryland Arena at the time, because they played 4 or 5 home games. And I basically put stamps on envelopes and took out the trash, hung signs and things of that nature. Then I got a job at the Avenue Times covering the Baltimore Bears semi-pro football team, who played at Patterson High School, which was one of my many high school destinations. And it just worked from there. I met Esther in 1992, and we've kind of known each other since then. And as NST evolved, we stayed in touch, and the rest is history.
Well, Bob, I listen to your show daily. I think it's probably one of the best shows on the radio.
Thank you very much.
Be careful. Two other guys.
I said one of the best shows on the radio. One of the best shows on the radio.
I don't want to say anything about the best of Baltimore magazine and City Paper. You read it.
So you're growing up. When is the lightning strike when you decide, hey, I want to get on the radio and do sports for a living?
Probably in my mid-20s. Because I thought when
you were about probably a freshman in college, about the time.
I just got my GED when I was 26, if I'm not mistaken. But when I was a kid, I thought my destiny, my dad owned 2 7-Elevens. So I thought I was gonna be pouring Slurpees for the rest of my life. And luckily I rebelled against that. And like I said, I went to broadcasting school because people kept telling me I had a good voice for it. Smoking since you were 12 years old or do that. And I just got into it. Of course, I grew up as a sports fan, and that helps. And I played sports to some level. I went to Calvert Hall for a year.
Yes.
They told me to leave after 6 months, but hey. Tried out for the fresh soft basketball team, went to one practice, got home at 7:30, said, that's enough of that. But yeah, I figured, take advantage of what you do best. And, I'm not the brightest guy in the world. I know a little bit about sports, and I followed that path.
Hey, no doubt to that. Going back growing up, I know you're a big basketball guy. Keep a close track on the local scene, the high school sports?
Not as much as I used to, because I did a recruiting show on onairsports.com like 10 years ago, Recruit This. And we were following the recruitment of Jawad Williams at the time, who wound up going to North Carolina. And everybody perceived him as a Maryland lean, and at the last minute, he kept blowing off his official visit to College Park. Anyway, wound up in North Carolina when Darty got the job, Matt Darty. And just the venom that was thrown towards this kid was mind-boggling to me. So at that time, I said, maybe we're taking it just a little too seriously. I still follow the Maryland recruits and the local kids, but... And then once my cousin got out of Kingsville in 2001, I still read the box scores and follow as much as I can, but I don't follow as closely as I used to.
Well, I'll tell you what, I coach over Calvert Hall now, and you see the same thing.
It's a good school.
I remember. You see the same thing, these kids are, 15, 16, 17, getting blasted on websites and blogs. It's a little over time.
Yeah, well, it's the nature of the beast that, they know, the kids know what's involved with the recruiting. Look at what's going on with Lance Stevenson and John Wall now. It's It's a circus. By the way, I'll break some news here with you, John McKay. Keith Kavanaugh saying that the Sean Painter will make his college destination on tonight. It's between Maryland and NC State.
There you go. You heard that here.
Or it could be somebody else. You never know. James basketball recruit.
Hey, you heard it here first. Sitting in with Bob Haney at Donna's Tavern. We're wrapping up. I am John McKay on WNST.net. Thanks for tuning in.
If you love Baltimore sports, you'll love WNST.net.